out to our show sponsor in the first round for the boxing gloves tonight, Everlast Boxing, the most iconic boxing brand in the world. Everlast Canada is the global leader in boxing and fitness equipment and isn't afraid to keep pushing boundaries while motivating and pushing you to take your fitness journey to the next level. We are honored to have their support and proud to have our fighters wearing Everlast gloves. Ladies and gentlemen, your first bout of the night is brought to you by Civilian Strong, coffee for the driven. This bout is sanctioned by the BC Athletic Commission, and the commissioner is Kelly Gilday. Judges for this fight are Ed Pearson, Ed Garner, and Rick Shannon. And now, to introduce the blue corner, welcome Daniel Roach. And introducing, in the red corner, Sean Archer.
If you're gonna be dumb, you gotta be tough. When you get knocked down, you gotta get back up. I ain't the sharpest knife in the drawer, but I know enough. Chicken fried. And I had this with badges frisk me to teach me how to swallow pride. I took advice no fool would take. I got some habits I can't shake. I ain't the sharpest E100 in the sack, but I know enough to know if you're gonna be done, you gotta be tough.
All right, fight fans. This fight is scheduled for 4 3-minute rounds of boxing in the super welterweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, from Toronto, an orthodox fighter weighing in at 150.8 pounds with a record of 1 win, no losses, wearing the black trunks. Let's introduce Daniel Roach. And introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, from Quesnel, BC, an orthodox fighter with a record of 1 win and no losses, weighing in at 147.8 pounds, wearing the black trunks with the silver trim, Ugly Sean Archer!
All right, well, here we go, bout
Your
number one.
Your referee for this bout is Greg Harrison.
Probably one of the best nicknames I've heard in a long time, Ugly Sean Archer. Absolutely. Robert, you fought Sean Archer a couple of years ago. What can we expect from him as he's transitioned now to the pro game? What did you see from him as an amateur, and what can you expect of him tonight?
That's right. I did have only that experience one time seeing him fighting in front of him, but I honestly don't recall too much of his style, his technique, but I remember him being aggressive. So I don't know if he translated that into the pros or if he's taken more pro approach and you know, timing it down and being more calculated.
This is a great fight to get things started here. Daniel, as they came to the center of the ring, seems to have a considerable height advantage. Be interesting to see if Sean gets inside.
And we're off.
Good jab to the body to get things started by Daniel. Sean Archer is coached by Stuart McClellan, a 30-fight pro veteran who is the former super welterweight CPBC champion. So great coach in his corner.
I don't know if you heard the music that Daniel Roach came out to, but I wonder if that was music of his own. Apparently he was a busker in Toronto and played the alto saxophone to make some extra money.
That's right. And doing some research leading up to the fights here.
Keep that head up, Lou. Keep that head up, please.
I read that Daniel Roach was a busker in Toronto and a big part of the jazz scene, but gave that up to focus on pro boxing.
He says it saved his life.
Yeah. That's right. Good start to the bout here. A lot of action early on. Sean Archer coming over the top here with big right hand, left hook, trying to make his way inside. Daniel's working his jab from the outside. Nice left hook.
That's that pressure.
Oh, good counter left there.
Pressure that I recall from Archer. Just keep coming forward. Look at that nonstop punch.
Yeah, he's working inside, landing that left hook and right hand. I'd like to see Daniel use his jab. He's got some reach there. He could box from the outside a little bit more. I think it's better suited to his style.
Absolutely, Ryan. I was just thinking that myself. You know, he should be using his feet and his reach advantage there to keep Sean at bay, but they're trading quite nicely inside the two lads. Very entertaining first exchanges in the first minute and a half.
For sure, quite a scrap.
It's a wild uppercut thrown by Sean Archer, but the left hook's landing at will right now. I'd like to see him go back to that.
Stop. Good job, fellas. Break. Here we go. Stop pushing. Stop pushing. Stop. Stop. All right. Get low in the middle. All right, here we go.
That's the jab I was talking about. You know, Daniel's got a significant height advantage. If he boxed from the outside, used that jab to land the right hand, I think he'd be in control of this fight. Instead, he's fighting on the inside and fighting Sean Archer's game here. So
agreed, Ryan.
Nice. 1-2.
Archer says, no way. Let's bring it. I mean, Sean Archer's from Quesnel. He's coached by Wally Dorn and Stuart McClellan. It's a really tough town. All the guys from Quesnel and Williams Lake. Always come to fight. They're ready to go on the road, willing to go on the road to fight anybody, anytime. Sean's definitely applied the pressure here in this opening round. I think Daniel Roach has tried to use his jab, but Sean Archer's definitely the aggressor, and I'd say he's landed the better shot so far through the first 2.5 minutes.
That's right. I feel like you can't forget, too, the first round, right? First round nerves, first fight. They're still just slugging him out, trying to find their ground, and I think I'm noticing lots of uppercuts, surprisingly.
Absolutely. I think the array of combinations are kind of going out. I think we're looking at 1 and 2 punch combinations right now. But a very decent end to a very interesting first round for these lads.
Yeah, solid first round. As I said, I think Sean Archer controlled the pace of the first half, maybe 3/4 of that round. Daniel Roach landed some clean shots at the end. It'll be interesting to see how the judges scored that.
Welcome to Seconds Out Boxing. It is an online coaching tutorial and class program that will get you in the best shape of your life. You can do this at home and learn how to box technically from real athletes. We'll have classes that we'll be rolling out every month featuring some of our community partners with pieces of equipment, and we will always be modifying down to body weight. We're so excited to share this with you. Keep your eyes out for Seconds Out Boxing.
Here we go, second round for Sean Archer versus Daniel Roach. Looking to see something about the same as the first round, maybe a little more pacing. What do you say, Tariq?
Absolutely. Lads coming out, looks like they're into the center of the ring, moving at quite the same area tactically that they were employing in the first round. So it'd be interesting to see if maybe this is actually going to be a theme for the night for these two lads. What about yourself, Ryan? What are you noticing in the first 30 seconds of this second round?
Yeah, I think, you know, I didn't hear what was said in the corner in between round. I'm hoping that Daniel's corner, tell him to just really reestablish his jab, work from the outside. He's landing some nice shots here early on. I think Sean's game plan's got to be get inside and work here. He can't fight at a distance, and when he gets inside, he's not throwing anything right now, so I'd like to see him pick up the pace. Some nice shots landed by Daniel here.
Absolutely. What I'm noticing is Daniel's right hands, actually, when he's throwing it when he can, is a very effective tool that he's using right now, and he's actually catching Sean a little bit too regularly for my liking.
And we see Sean's got a cut here on his forehead. I'm not sure how it happened, whether it's from a punch or heads coming together, but...
I want to say I saw a headbutt in there against the ropes, but I will say this round, Sean's doing a lot more head movement. I'm sure the corner told him to. He was going in straight down the middle, and it's helping him, but he has his hands low a lot.
Got caught with a nice right hand. A little bit of right hand behind the head there. Sean's moving his head inside, but not letting his hands go as much as he should.
Yes, indeed, and just a message for tonight's first sponsor of the evening is Civilian Strong Coffee. That's coffee for the driven. I know all the lads have been on Civilian Strong's coffee leading up to the fights, keep them nice and stimulated, so it seems that these two lads have got plenty of energy.
Nice left hook to the body by Roach there. Referee is probably going to go clean up the cut here and take a look.
Looks like a deep cut there, Ryan. And like I said, I didn't actually see the event, but Robbie said that you think it's a coming of two heads there.
I thought I saw a head clash against the ropes there, and then it was led up with a right hand, over top right hand by Roach. Probably helped set that in.
The ringside doctor there is Dr. Gosal. He's an experienced combat sport, boxing, mixed martial arts ringside physician. He's going to let the fight go unless there's no way it can happen. Nice jab landed by Sean. Could double that up and then land a straight right hand. He's a little bit wild right now. I'd like to see him straighten up his shots.
Absolutely. I think if he tidies up, his footwork moving in off that double jab, especially fighting a taller opponent, I think he could be a wee bit more lucky with these punches, Ryan.
Daniel's being patient here in the second round. We've got about 30 seconds left to go. Sticking out his jab and trying to counter Sean as he comes in with the right hand or the uppercut. Nice left hook again. Nice right hand.
Yeah, I think Daniel's doing quite a good job shooting off the blocks, and he's able to catch Sean a couple of times there. Be interested to see if Sean is able to keep up his head moving to keep a wee bit out of that range there.
Both of these guys are 1-0. Sean Archer won his pro debut in Mexico last year. Daniel Roach is also 1-0. So both of these guys really want to go 2-0 to advance their professional career here.
Yes, indeed.
Nice uppercut to end there. Snuck it in.
Good second round. Going back to their corners for some advice. As I said, Stuart McClellan's here in the corner talking to Sean Archer, a very experienced pro himself. I'm sure he's got some advice for his boxer here.
What are you thinking, Ryan, coming out in the end of that second round? Going into their corners, what are their coaches going to be saying to them? How about Sean's coach, for example?
I think Sean's got to let his hands go more. He's moving his head. He's trying to work his way inside, but he's really trying to land one big shot, maybe two. He's got to let his hands go. Daniel Roach had a good second round. I think he used his height and his distance, his reach to his advantage, established that jab and landed some clean shots. I think Sean's got to work his way inside and really start to let his hands go. Also in the corner there, you see Manny Sobral, 1988 Olympian, also an IBO World Champion. So really strong corner man in Sean Archer's corner. Let's see what he comes out doing here in round three.
I'd like to see Sean have hands up more after he finishes and throws his combinations. I find that's where he's getting caught. And I'd like to see Roach kind of step back, throw that jab out longer with that reach he has.
And for tonight's sponsor in the third round, they're also tonight's co-main event sponsor. We got Pizza Hut. Pizza Hut's Canada's favorite place to order pizza, pasta, wings, and so much more for fast and delicious delivery or pickup. Use code 839 to snag one of Pizza Hut's favorite pizzas for $10.
Again, nice 1-2 from Daniel Roach. Just measuring Sean at this point. Sean's getting quite wild. Just hoping he'll land those big left hooks and right hand.
Absolutely. I'm noticing that Daniel's composure and his ability to read the game right now is actually on point, and I think it's going to do him a pretty good stead in this opening minute.
Yeah, I start to see Daniel sitting down on his punches a little bit more. I think he's found his range. He's getting comfortable. He's digging to the body. That was a nice left hook to the body. I think he's heard Sean Archer here going back to the body. And he's down. Really nice work here in the third round by Daniel Roach.
Took that deep breath. Let's hope he can recoup.
That all started with a left hook to the body. He came back to the head and went back to the body again.
Okay, take a step towards me.
Let's see if Sean Archer can come back here, but Daniel's looking strong here in the third round. Still 2 minutes to go.
Like you said, Ryan, I think he's found his pace, he's found his range, and I think he's quite comfortable sitting on his punches and landing those effective shots.
Daniel should go back to the body here. He knows it's worked before. Give himself a bit of distance. Nice, again, left hook to the body.
Ooh, Sean's got to keep those hands up, head up, and eyes on his opponent.
Right hand! Where's the right hand?
Daniel Roach is effectively landing shots downstairs to Sean Archer's body here, and there's still a minute and a half to go here in this third round. Sean's looking tired.
Yeah, he is indeed, Ryan. I think that body shot winded him a little bit and has taken his legs out a little bit. So still got a minute and 20 left of this round for him to get a couple of breaths in and maybe make a little comeback.
Right hook to the body, cuz. Otherwise, you can see these shit. Off the jab. You're loading up, bro.
Yeah, Sean Archer's coming out wild here. I think he's looking for that big shot right now. He's got to find a way to get himself back into this third round. Daniel Roach seems to have eased off just a little bit. Maybe trying to catch his breath here before he finishes strong here. We've got about a minute left in the third round.
Yes, indeed. I think he was quite industrious there in that second minute, especially landing those combinations. And I think he's obviously pacing himself a little bit, thinking about the next round.
Fortunately, that cut doesn't seem to be affecting Sean Archer too much. He's coming on strong here in the last third of this round. Trying to mix it up a little bit with Daniel Roach, but he's having a hard time landing the shots. He seems to be just short, having a trouble getting inside and landing those big shots. Nice left hook, but Daniel Roach's right hand's high.
If I'm hearing correct there, I hear Manny in the corner telling Sean Archer, stay low, as a previous pupil from Manny Sobro. He was very adamant at always saying, if you're the smaller opponent, stay smaller.
So let's take a look at the replay here. We've got Sean Archer getting dropped here in the third round. So obviously a 10-8 round. Daniel Roach did a really good job midway through. We see Sean Archer down. That all started with a left hook to the body, and then a second left hook to the body, which put Sean down.
And the placement is absolutely sublime there,
very
Ryan.
Well,
and I think you know, technically that was absolutely pristine.
So here we go, round four. I mean, you know, maybe you gave Sean Archer the first round, but round two and certainly round three went to Daniel Roach. Sean's going to have to find something in his reserve here if he's going to win this fight. Obviously, the last round was a 10-8 in favor of Daniel Roach. So interesting to wish we could hear what Stuart and Manny are telling to Sean right now.
I am agreeing with you there, Ryan. I think Daniel's kind of moving away ahead in the lead now, and I think it's a big round for Sean if he's going to make a comeback in this fight.
Manny putting some Vaseline on Sean Archer's cut here. Seconds out. Here we go. Fourth and final round of this bout.
Establishing that jab.
Hands up, man.
Roach knowing what he needs to do. Pump that jab back to back.
Good jab by Sean here.
Yeah, he's finally using his reach to his advantage now. And I think it's making it a little bit more difficult for Sean to get inside.
Sean's game, he's tough here. Obviously, he got dropped in the third round, but he's coming out strong. Getting caught with a lot of jabs, as you said, Robert. I'd like to see a little bit more head movement or him to keep his hands higher, because he is getting caught with a lot of jabs here again to start the fourth round. But game, he's coming out. He's coming to fight.
A warrior for sure, yes. A warrior for sure.
He is indeed. I'd like to see Roach's right hand a little bit more often as well. You know, I think it's doing him a little bit of a disservice. He's landing all those very crisp, clean, long jabs. It'd be good to see that right hand used a little bit more.
That's a great observation, I think. All right, guys. If he backed up all those stiff jabs. Yeah.
Absolutely.
Some of these body shots here by Daniel Roach in the fourth round are just on the belt line here, and you actually heard the referee calling for that to keep his punches up.
Yes, indeed. I think especially with the height difference as well, it's sometimes a little bit hard, especially when you're a little bit more fatigued to be as pristine with your aim. So it would be good, actually. The referee's making a good point, keeping those shots above the belt.
Strong fourth round here by Sean Archer. He is finding a way inside. He is letting his hands go a lot more than he did in the second and third round. Daniel seems to have dialed it back a little bit, and as we said before, I'm not sure this is his fight against Sean Archer. I don't think he should be staying on the inside, but rather setting things up off his jab, his right hand, and going to the body.
Absolutely right there, Ryan. I think we're seeing reflections of the first couple of minutes of the first round where he was very much fighting Sean's fight. I think his success in the second and third round was when he started to move into Daniel's fight. So we'll see how the last minute of this goes.
We got 45 seconds left to go here in this fight. I think Sean really needs to take this fight to Daniel if he's going to win. Nice body shot by Daniel again, landed. Good left hook upstairs. Nice right uppercut.
Again, when he's utilizing his right hand, Ryan, I think he's been quite successful with it each time. It'd be good to see him step out of that pocket and maybe come back in with a quick right hand. He seems to be quite successful with it when he actually throws it.
I am surprised by Sean getting that kind of a second wind here late in the last round here, but something you don't always see. But he really wants it, that's for sure.
Nice right hand down the stretch. We got 10 seconds to go in our opening bout of the evening.
Is that a little blood I see on the right side?
Just noticing that there, Rob, and a little cut under Roach's right eye there, but it doesn't seem to have affected the last 10 seconds of that round.
There we go. The end of bout one of the evening. Judges handing their scorecards over to our referee. We're going to take one last look here at the knockdown in the third round. So here we go. Right to the body, right upstairs. And there's that left hook. Two double left hooks, followed by a right uppercut. That was a nice series there by Daniel Roach in the third round. You know what, guys? I thought that was a really strong round, actually, to finish things off by Sean Archer. You know, obviously, Daniel took the second and third, 10-9, 10-8. Could have given the last round, perhaps, to Sean Archer, some nice inside work. Obviously, did not want to quit. There he is, smiling at the camera. What did you guys think of our opening bout of the evening?
I thought it was a great way to kick off the evening. I think once Daniel Roach started to get into his rhythm a wee bit, started sitting in his punches, understanding that his range was making a difference, I think he did well. I think he was the better of the two on the night, I think, with his combination punching. I think he made the right choices at the right times, and I think that might just edge it for him in the evening. What about yourself, Rob?
100% what I like to see to open up a fight. You got a puncher and a guy who can really stick that jab and keep his distance, but... they're only on this is their second fight, and one of them's going to come out with a win for their second win with zero losses, and they both really want it, and so that's the kind of fight you want to start a show with.
There you look at Daniel Roach as the cameras zoom in on him. He does actually have a small right cut over his right eyelid, so both of these guys taking home some battle scars from their second professional fight. As we wait for the judges' scorecards, we'll look ahead to the next bout of the evening. Really interesting historical fight for professional boxing here in Canada. Jay Byard versus Hassan Ossani is the first Bridgerweight or classic heavyweight match here in Canada. This weight class was established fairly recently, I think no more than 4 or 5 months ago. And so as we wait for the judges' scorecards, you know, excited to make some professional boxing history this evening at Empire Boxing Promotions, The Resurgence.
Absolutely.
So seems that the referee is bringing both boxers to the center of the ring. We're going to turn it over to our MC for the official result.
After four rounds of boxing in the super welterweight division, we go to the scorecards. All three judges score this bout 39-36. For the winner by unanimous decision, Daniel Roach.
Well, there you have it. I think the judges saw it the same way we did. Obviously, they gave one round there, I believe, to Sean Archer. But that knockdown went a long way for Daniel Roach to get his second professional victory. As we said before, Daniel's from Toronto by way of Bermuda. So really great for him to be able to make it out to here to Vancouver for his second professional bout and his second professional win.
Aye, absolutely, Ryan. It was great display by both pugilists tonight. I think both of them moving into the second fight, it's evident that they've both got a bright career ahead of them. I think they're both exciting fighters, and I would definitely like to see both of them in action again sometime soon.
Congratulations to both of them.
Yes,
that's well said.
So we're going to take a quick break here. As you can see, due to COVID protocols, the ring is being cleaned in between every single bout, as well as a long list of other COVID protocols that Empire Boxing Promotions has put into effect for this evening's event. We have no spectators, mandatory masks by all of the referees, judges, and everyone else here in the facility. Pre-screening protocols were in place at the door, and all of our boxers behind scenes in the change room are set up in cohorts. So following all the strictest safety protocols for COVID-19, we'll let the volunteers here clean the ring, and we will be back shortly for our second bout of the evening.
I can hear you. Yeah, I can hear.
Daniel, congratulations on your second professional victory there. Great fight. Happy to have you here in Vancouver, British Columbia. How does it feel to get your second professional victory behind you?
I mean, I feel good, but I think it was pretty sloppy performance. I could have definitely boxed better, but I'm happy to get the win and move on. I just got to move on.
You seem to get a lot more comfortable in that second, and especially in that third round. You found your range, found your distance, and then you started to go to the body, and ultimately you dropped Sean Archer in that third round. Talk to us about the body shot you landed that ultimately led to the knockdown.
Well, I've been working on my left hook to the body like just nonstop, and even in training. I love the left hook to the body, and I really wanted to make an impression with it. And I was happy it put him down, but I could have done more damage with it. So I was a bit frustrated with that, but I'm always going to be frustrated with something in my performances, you know?
Always room to improve. Well, where do you go from here? I know you're from Toronto. Things are shut down right now in Ontario. So, you know, you're 2-0 now. Looking up, where do you go from here?
Just keep training. Back to the drawing board, back to the gym, back to road work, back to the shadow box, everything. There's always room to improve, so I'm happy to be able to do this in the pandemic. So thank you to Empire Boxing Promotions for this opportunity, first of all. And yeah.
Well, we appreciate you coming out. Thanks for being here in Vancouver with us, and hopefully we'll have you back soon. Good luck in your next fight.
Thank you. Thank you. Peace.